Hi friends, I'm Prairie Vintage Jewelry. My name is Linda. I'm an energy intuitive reader here on YouTube. I use spirit and my intuition and the tarot to communicate energies to you, the viewer. And today we'll be taking a look at the next big blessing or big surprise coming, pleasant surprise coming into your life. So I did a reading earlier today and I felt really not very comfortable about how I left pile number three. Because I want to bring positivity. So I wanted to look at the next big blessing, okay? So not necessarily any sort of energy shifts, but more of what positive energy shifts could you expect next, okay? And maybe it's something unexpected, maybe it's something completely expected, but it is something positive and it definitely is your next big blessing coming in, okay? So take a look at these three piles. You may be drawn to one, two, or three piles. That's absolutely fine. Let your intuition guide you into which pile is calling to you. And if you are drawn to more than one pile, just means there's multiple messages in there for you. Pile number one is this obsidian cat right here. Pile number two is this beautiful hare. Rabbit, and pile number two is this beautiful mother of pearl tortoise. Okay, so whichever pile you're intuitively drawn to, one, two, or three, the pick will be in the timestamp and in the pinned comment. It will take you directly to your pick and we will take a look at the surprises coming in for you. See you at your pick. Hello, beautiful. Pile number one. If you pick the black obsidian cat, then this is your pile. Now, this reading was inspired by my beautiful pile number three from my previous reading I did today, in which I felt I left it kind of not very happy. So I wanted to bring some good news, and this is all about the big blessings coming in, next big pleasant surprise coming in energetically to you. Okay, so I pre-shuffled the oracle cards and we will pull some tarot, but let's take a look at the messages spirit wants to communicate about your next big blessing. All right, so we have Alcyone, Ecopius the Seer, visionary. I chart the stars, signs, and symbols to craft magic. Wow, very handsome. Something about these three orbs are catching my attention. Very interesting. Yes, and look, you have the crystals coming up, very similar. And blue does represent the throat chakra. Although this is talking about visionary, I feel like there's something about something you see or you have been seeing for a while that you're able to speak out about, which I find very interesting. Something kind of close to your heart matter, something you feel emotionally tied to. Okay, so let's take a look at what this means. So we have Moonstone, nurturing divine feminine intuitive. Drawing power from the divine feminine, Moonstone connects you to the goddess energy, activating your intuition. Moonstone can boost clairvoyance gifts and metaphysical powers, asking that you trust in the unknown beyond what you can see in this realm. The reflective nature of the crystal is much like the moon phases themselves, a cycle of change from new beginnings to full release. Moonstone balances masculine energy with the feminine touch, teaching the art of receptivity and serendipity. It is especially potent during the waxing moon. Cancer, Libra, Scorpio, and the moon. Very interesting. Okay, and then we have this crystal right here. And this is blue topaz, solar vitality and amplify. Inspired by the sun, blue topaz draws its strength from solar energy, radiating warmth, generosity, strength, and vitality to those who seek it. With an impact as huge as the limitless sky, Blue topaz's power is potent, magnifying psychic abilities and inner peace. Use this crystal in conjunction with your affirmations and visualization, as it will amplify your intentions as you envision your future. Blue topaz stimulates creativity, a thirst for knowledge. granting the ability to express emotions and thoughts in a clear, profound way. Sagittarius, Sun, Jupiter. I've not even looked at these, and I'm telling you guys, all three of these cards, I'm so excited for you guys. Pile number one. How beautiful of an energy I'm feeling here. And I feel like there is a seeing and a seeing of truth that is coming intuitively that you're able to communicate. And I feel like you are speaking a high truth that is very much close to your heart. And it is aligning you to your truer self. I feel like there is this unity that you're able to bring in from your intuition, from a knowing into reality. Okay. And then the fact that we have visionary here, and we talk about in here we're talking about what it is that you can visually sorry, I want to see where we saw that. Yes, it says use this crystal in conjunction with affirmations and visualization as it will amplify your intentions as you envision your future. I feel like whatever you're able to speak out loud, whatever you're able to see, I won't be surprised if we see the Magician card come out today. I feel like whatever you've been envisioning in your mind, you're now able to manifest in this world. Okay, so I feel like there is this heavy intent focus on what you've been concentrating on, what you've been wishing for, what you've been trying to accomplish, what you've been seeing in your mind's eye, and bringing it into this world. Okay, which is absolutely amazing. And I feel like there is this heavy emphasis on intuition and I feel like what you're doing is maybe where you've been doubting your own ability to. I feel like they're okay. Well, we'll see all the cards before I get too excited. But I just feel so excited for you guys, pile number one, because this is like, I feel this is very new energy for you. Okay. What do we have? Thinker with the number 44. So 44 could be significant, could be your age. 4 plus 4 is 8, and 8 talks about it's the infinity symbol, which is an infinite amount of opportunity and potential. And I feel like the stars talk about this wish come true, this. Something we didn't think we could attain. I feel like something you've been in heavy contemplation about and maybe intuitively have known, but there was an inability to know how to bring it into this world. Okay. Wow, this is pretty powerful, you guys. Pile number one. You're gonna have to tell me how you guys manifest and bring this in. All right, so this is the intuitive deck here with this picture of looks like an older woman whittling on a stick, creating something, and she has butterfly wings, and it's called the mentor with the number 48 or the number 12. Affirmation: I respect and learn from the wisdom of my elders. Let's move the cat up there. From your elders. Wow, something profound is going on here with you guys. All right, so feeling fear is a call for love. I feel like for some of you guys, maybe where you guys were held back by fear, there is now this new inspiration to vocalize and bring it into awareness and bring it into your life. Where it once was a thought, you're now able to visualize and bring it in with, well, it's craft magic here. So I feel like, and I chart the stars, signs, and symbols to craft magic. Stars. So it's like this wish, this yeah, there's like this unbelievable goal that you've been trying to achieve, maybe out of fear. I do feel like it involves emotions here with the love. I feel like there's an ability to express oneself around something that they're emotionally invested with, and something with the elder. So let's keep going and see what we have. I consume only my fair share. Third eye with the blue again. It's almost like being able to vocalize what it is that you're seeing in your subconscious mind, what you know to be true in your subconscious mind. I consume only my fair share, okay? And I'm gonna move this over. We have Peacock. Wow, look at this beautiful card. Well, the Peacock talks about somebody who is definitely proud and showy and attracts a lot of attention. And the peacock's eyes talk about protection. And the peacock can also be talking about ego in some way, but I feel like what I'm picking up is this blue energy coming again from this peacock. Okay, let's keep going. So we have 32 with Merkaba, sorry. The frequency of Merkaba supports our ability to use our consciousness to traverse into other layers of reality and dimensions. It activates our access to our Akashic inheritance as well. Oh my goodness, merging the total totality of our experiences into our present to serve our highest purpose. You guys, this is the most beautiful reading. I'm so glad I took the time to do this reading today. I was contemplating. I feel like there's this higher purpose, and I'm really excited for you guys. This higher purpose, there's this, I'm gonna try to keep it together here. This higher calling, this higher purpose, there's something that you've been trying to manifest, but I feel like this, whatever this is something that's been unattainable, and maybe you've been you've been trying to bring this forward, but I feel like maybe you've been held back in some sort of way, either not knowing how to manifest it into this 3D world, or something to do with yourself kind of getting in the way. But I feel like recently, or coming up real soon here as part of your blessing, you're able to use your wisdom in a way that's able to bring forward something that seemed unattainable and unachievable that you've desired into this world. And I feel like you're able to express exactly what it is that you're feeling, but also bring to this 3D world what it is that you're envisioning in your mind for yourself that involves your specific purpose. Okay. Yeah, I feel like it's very powerful. We'll take a look at timelines too. Take a look at when this will be happening, but let's look at some tarot to get a little bit more. Spirit, thank you so much for that powerful message here for pile number one. Can we get some tarot around what they can expect here for their next big blessing, this next big surprise? Energetically, what are they going to see here for positive, pleasant surprises coming in to their life? We have the Four of Pentacles. Okay, let's keep going. We have the Five of Wands. Let's keep going. One more here from this deck. And then we'll pull from our other deck. We have the Seven of Pentacles. Okay, let's move these again. Sorry, over here. Let's move these. And I'm going to pull from this deck over here, and we'll pull some more and see what we see. Spirit, clear and concise for beautiful pile number one. Thank you so much. And thank you so much, pile number one, for allowing me into your beautiful energy. Take a look at your next big blessing. Oh, okay. Well, we'll take the one that flipped. In fact, I feel like taking those right there that landed on the cards. We do have one more. Oh, this is this one. That one went wandering off. Okay. What do we have? Okay, so the one that wanted to reveal itself was this Eight of Wands. So we'll leave that one first. And we also have the Two of Wands. And sorry, I'm just shuffling these over. Some room, and we have the magician. Okay, wait a minute. Did I not say we were gonna see the magician? I am not surprised to see the magician here, you guys. You guys are really powerful beings here. You guys are definitely manifesting something into life. And then justice. Wow. Okay. So let's see if this is in frame for you guys. Okay, perfect. So excited. So I feel like you guys have been really conflicted. I'm putting a lot of energy and effort into something that you've been, that you guard, almost like it's very special to you, okay? Because the Four of Pentacles talks about hanging on to something out of fear of maybe if you let go, you might lose it or you might lose a piece of it, okay? So it's sometimes can be looked at as a card of lack because you might be looking at an area that if you were to let go or take a risk or take a chance or invest in an area, you might lose out rather than if I give a little, I might gain a lot. But I feel like your energy here has been your conflict. But I feel like what's happening now, and see the stars here in the background, I feel like there is a shift in recognizing this energy that you have more stars here, that you've been investing and putting in energy. And this is putting in energy into an area to take harvest or reap your reward for where you've been investing. And I feel like not only is your investment coming in very quickly here with this Eight of Wands, I feel like there is a heavy emphasis on communication with the throat chakra. Okay, I feel like you're able to communicate your truth. And I feel like there is a breakthrough in an area that's been very held back, very stuck, and potentially has caused conflict. And it's almost caused you to look at a situation as hopeless or almost like a feeling of giving up because you weren't quite sure how to navigate, okay? But I feel like what this is doing is it's opening up an opportunity here for you, okay, to have to expand your horizons when it comes to opening up your future, okay? With the Two of Wands, this talks about options. This talks about having a choice. And justice also talks about the two scales here with the balance. I feel like there's a situation that opens up for you in order to bring balance to your life. And I feel like you have, with this magician, brought in an opportunity where potentially things were closed, where things might have not have seen like they were possible, like there might have not have seemed to be an option, like there might have not have seemed to be a way. There's now a way. There's a way to bring balance. There's a way to bring justice to a situation. And I can't help but feel there might be someone else involved here. Okay. I do feel like there is, because typically in the Two of Wands, there's one individual, two wands, and he's making a choice which way to go. I feel like in this depiction here, you're being supported by somebody in your decision. Okay, somebody's got your back. You have either a friend, a soulmate, a partner, a parent, a sibling, a really good friend, a trusted advisor, a mentor, somebody who's able to really have your back and kind of walk you through balancing things out. And I feel like there's a sense of liberation. I feel like this bat is like liberated, okay, with justice. Speaking of liberation, I feel like where maybe you've been not liberated in your life, you're now liberated, which I feel is giving you this sense of purpose, okay? Wow, this is very exciting. Now, what exactly, sorry, this is the mentor. Did we not say a mentor? Okay, I feel like there is a heavy emphasis here on a mentor. Okay, and a mentor could be anybody in your life that's assisting you or supporting you. Somebody maybe you look up to, I respect and learn from the wisdom of my elders. Could be somebody who's very experienced. Doesn't necessarily mean someone who is old, although it could be someone older than you. But I feel like this person is experienced in this area. And I feel like there is an ability for you to lean on this person and learn from what it is that they have to offer to you in order for you to manifest your own reality, to open up doors and options for you to balance things out. Where I feel like you've had maybe, yeah, this is giving me heavy liberation than it is balance. I feel like there is a sense of liberation, freedom, where you were stuck, where you were immobilize, where you were thinking and thinking about maybe what you wanted or the potential opportunities. It could have been anything, you could have anything, but how do you go about it and how do you take that step, right? With the star, that's like getting one's wish. That's like absolute, that's like an absolute dream come true, wishes coming true. And I feel like even this raccoon's like has his eye on the star. I feel like stars are really everywhere in this reading. There's this connection with the divine. There's this knowing and being able to bring in what it is that you know to be true for you and actually manifest it into this world. Okay. I consume only my fair share. Yeah, remember I was talking about this liberation? I feel like you haven't been able to enjoy an area of your life. You've been held back or blocked, or for some reason, not allowing yourself, or for whatever reason, you haven't been able to enjoy a part of your life that now you're feeling liberated to explore. Okay, this talks about exploration. This talks about having choices and now options, decisions to be able to contemplate and move forward rather than feeling stuck or like you don't have a choice or you don't have options here. Wow, this is really beautiful. Okay, so what I'm going to do is pull some more tarot so we can see some more about this beautiful energy, you guys, pile number one, and then we will pull some timing so we know when this energy is coming in. So let's pull some of these. So, Spirit, thank you so much for that beautiful message for pile number one. Can we see some more regarding this beautiful blessing? Anything more pile number one needs to know about this blessing, this pleasant surprise coming in for them? So we have the Six of Wands. Beautiful. We have the King of Cups, you guys. I love this reading. I'm just so excited for you guys. Wow, and the energy I'm feeling is absolutely amazing. Three of Cups, yes. Beautiful energy I'm feeling. Okay, let's pull some of these as well. Anything further, Spirit, that pile number one should know. Okay, we have the Ace of Wands. We have Death. Let's shuffle these over. Pull one more. And we have Justice again, different deck. Liberation. You guys are free. I feel like you guys have been not free. I feel this is exactly how I feel. You know how I feel? And I'm so happy and elated for you guys. I feel like I've been released from years and years of oppression, or years and years of holding myself back, or years and years of feeling fear, or held back, or imprisoned, or unable to move forward, or seeing things as other people's things and not my own, and now being able to go after what it is that I want with this Ace of Wands. I feel like there's a huge transformation here with death. I feel like an old phase of being is now put to rest, and you're now able to transform and transition into a new period with absolute vigor and desire here with this Ace of Wands. This is a new beginning, an inspired new beginning, okay, to liberate yourself. And I feel you're 100,000% successful with this Six of Wands. Six of Wands talks about the victory lap, somebody getting accolades and receiving the recognition they deserve. And I feel like this is giving me this heavy peacock energy. It's like the confidence. Yeah, like you're feeling confident, you're feeling appreciated, you're feeling rewarded, you're feeling very victorious here, okay? And the King of Cups is a very emotionally deep person, feeling their emotions. And I was feeling heavy King of Cups from here, but I feel like this King of Cups is able to communicate with this blue orb here. This is like chakra energy, like throat chakra. I feel like he's able to, and it's by his ear, and it's by his throat, and it's by his heart. So I feel like this King of Cups, wow, I'm getting goosebumps here, you guys. This energy is really giving me A whole new charge as I drop a whole bunch of things. Okay, so this King of Cups is able to hear, okay, and listen and be in tune with his environment. He's very attentive. He can see, okay, with the seer here, is a visionary. He's able to communicate from a place of emotions and depth and heart when it comes to areas of intuition and wishes and subconscious and dreams and fantasy and all things wonderful that maybe at one time seemed like too good to be true or something that wasn't able to manifest here. I feel like this King of Cups is coming forward to manifest this and be successful with the confidence here. Okay, and yeah, I feel like this Three of Cups talks about that celebration, that victory. Also talking about the network of people. So I feel like there is someone, if not multiple people in your life that you're able to learn from that help you to navigate through this. Okay, maybe where you felt really alone, now you're feeling like you can depend on other people. But I do see this being celebrations, and Six of Wands is definitely celebration. So I see there's like this celebratory, happy, vitality, energy, confidence, and yeah, confidence here with the Ace of Wands. This is somebody full of vitality, very confident, very driven, very passionate. Whereas I feel like maybe in the past this area has been not so much, okay? But I feel like there's this turn and there is this rebirth, and maybe where you felt stuck, now you're able to turn things into life, give it life again, be liberated, bring in balance. Okay, wow. So let's take a look. Let's ask Spirit for when can you expect this beautiful energy to come in? Spirit, can we get some timelines here? We have get more information. Okay, so we're gonna see some more here. I do feel like your ability to rely on sign symbols and stars in order to craft your own magic. And here with the support and the ability to use our consciousness to traverse into other layers of realities and dimensions, it activates our access to the Akashic inheritance as well. Wow, as well, merging the totality of our experiences into present to serve our highest purpose. So I feel like this is a lesson that you're learning, and I think Spirit wants you to. That's the whole blessing, is that you're able to figure this on your own. And I think maybe this is where you've been stuck, maybe where you've been contemplating on how to bring this forward. And so I don't know that we're going to get a whole lot here from Spirit, but we'll ask for a bit more here as far as timelines. So when can pile number one expect to see some change here for this blessing? So we have you're ready. So you're ready. I think that the timing is now, and this is probably why it feels so invigorated. I feel like this is like very charged energy. I feel like you're ready to do this. You're ready to speak your truth, hear your truth, communicate your truth, and your truth is what you feel in your heart, intuitively what you're connected to. Okay, what you've been contemplating here, what you've been pondering. A sense of liberation, having the confidence to step forward, being victorious here, trusting your third eye, whatever symbols, synchronicities you've been able to download, and it's your time to consume your fair share. Because I feel like for a long time you've possibly put yourself last in this area, okay, and you haven't been able to celebrate and really charge forward. Maybe out of fear, okay, but it's this feeling fear is a call for love, okay, so. I mean, love is definitely emotions here. So maybe you're feeling fear around going after what it is that you truly desire. Okay, passions, desire, emotions. Yeah, heavy contemplation here, held back energy, but I feel like you're breaking free from that. Absolutely beautiful energy. Pile number one, your next big blessing is beautiful. I love the blue. You might want to get a piece of moonstone here or this blue topaz. Okay, this may definitely help. Solar vitality, amplify, nurturing, divine feminine, and intuitive. Absolutely beautiful. All right, so thank you so much. Pile number one. I hope you enjoy this reading as much as I did, and I will leave this with you. If you're drawn to another pile, join me there. If not, I will leave you with this. Thank you so much. Bye. Hello, my gorgeous. Pile number two. If you pick this bunny, rabbit, hare, whatever you want to call it, stone carving, then this is your reading. And I'm so excited to share this message for you, inspired by my previous reading today. Poor pile number three. I felt very drawn to leave something positive because the communication there wasn't super positive, and I wanted to pass along big blessing. Okay, next big blessing, pleasant surprise. What's coming in that you're either going to be very surprised about, or maybe you were expecting to come in, but it's something positive, pleasurable. Next big blessing. Now I have shuffled these cards. We'll take a look at timelines. We'll also pull some tarot, but let's see what spirit wants to communicate. Beautiful pile number one. I just came out of absolutely love that reading. All right, so we have Selenial. Selenial 24, the little star divine. My inner child is whole and complete. Oh my goodness, look at this beautiful card. And we have the little green star here, which talks about heart chakra, and then all these hearts here, inner child. Okay, so my inner child is whole and complete. Beautiful. And then we have 11 by the book. Aw, talk about child. We have the father, mother, and the baby elephant here. Feeling a very strong family connection here, tradition. Let's keep going. So we have this beautiful crystal right here. It's called the Tanzine Aura Quartz, Enchantment, Cosmic, and Alchemy. Cosmic alignment is here. Tanzine Aura Quartz brings equilibrium to our multidimensional states, melding mind and body for spiritual balance. With indigo rays vibrating high, this stone heightens the ability to see and communicate beyond this world. Tanzine Aura Quartz gently opens your crown chakra, creating a channel between the divine and your body. Made from the rare metal indium, this crystal brings mystical qualities to a higher understanding of one's metaphysical abilities. You are more powerful than you think. Virgo, Pisces, and Uranus. Very interesting. Let's keep going. Ooh, look at this green. I'm feeling there's heavy heart chakra energy coming through here. What is this? This is Jade, wisdom, abundance, and good luck. Jade is highly prized and sacred, a wonderful stone for protection and healing, known as a dream stone. Jade will stimulate messages and channel them into your dreams when placed on your third eye chakra. The ultimate good luck charm. Jade promotes prosperity in every aspect of your life by opening the heart chakra and boosting your ability to receive. Wealth is nothing without your health. And jade is a reminder of this true abundance, amplifying the good fortune of your vitality. Remember, you are a spiritual being having a human experience. Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Libra, and Venus. I feel like there's a heavy emphasis on reminding you that you are a spiritual being. There's these metaphysical abilities that you have and mystical qualities for you not to forget. So we have cosmic alchemy, enchantment, wisdom, abundance, and good luck, with a heavy emphasis here on the heart chakra. All right. So we have this card right here. She looks like she might be concerned about something. Let's take a look at this intuition. Yes, 18, the worrier affirmation. I can handle whatever life brings to me. Okay. Definitely strength here coming through. Healing myself heals my lineage. You guys, lineage, healing yourself, working on your inner child. This is so beautiful. I regard all altars with respect. Beautiful. Look at this freedom. All right. And I'm also getting here, a choice of sorts, okay? A choice you have here coming up. Honeybee. Wow, beautiful. That's a beautiful card. Honeybees are very dedicated and they work together. I feel like there's a strong sense and support from family and network. There's also heavy earth energy coming through here with Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Healing, 29, more healing, you guys. The frequency of healing supports our intrinsic ability to restore our health and wholeness by consciously using the information that comes to us through our senses and harmonizing everything accordingly. Okay, you guys are healing very much so here. Okay, but I think what spirit is saying is you're healing the lineage of your ancestors and your inner child. And I feel like this blessing is that you guys are able to not only heal yourself, or maybe you've been held back, but you're also able to mend something that has been broken for a long time when it comes to your heritage, your ancestors, and your lineage, on and on and on, that have been passed down to you, that maybe you've been tasked with having to heal and repair your heart chakra and complete this healing for your lineage. And I feel like by the book here, I feel like a lot of you guys have been very dedicated to what it takes in order to, yeah, dedication with this honeybee, putting in effort, doing the work required, the shadow work. I feel like some of you guys have been even involved with prayer and higher power here with the altars. But I feel like there's an option, there's an opportunity now for you that's coming up that maybe you guys weren't ready for, because the healing needed to be complete. Okay, and I feel here this healing is coming to an end. I feel like there has been worry around this area. This area has been kind of like a thorn in your side. Okay, you've been worried about it. It's been maybe giving you a lot of anxiety. The fact that I can handle whatever life brings to me, I feel like you've faced this, or you will be facing this head on, your ability to heal yourself and your lineage and move forward with your dedication and your persistence, persistent effort. Okay, I feel like this healing is definitely goes beyond just yourself. I feel that there's this deep connection to past lives of either yourself or your ancestors. Okay, and I feel very strongly here with Heals My Lineage that you're doing service to your family before you, and I really feel like it's in this heart chakra area. Okay, and let's read this one more time. The frequency of healing supports our intrinsic ability to restore our health and wholeness by consciously using the information that comes to us through our senses and harmonizing everything accordingly. Yes, because the honeybee is more 3D and working in this 3D world. So I feel like you're taking what you're working on here and you're able to bring that inwards in order to heal yourself. Okay, let's see some more with the tarot, because this is very interesting. I'm gonna move these over. Move these over so we can ask spirit if we can get some more about your beautiful energy. Okay, we had the King of Wands coming out right away. Beautiful. What else, spirit, for pile number two and this beautiful energy that they can expect for their next big blessing? Thank you so much, pile number two, for allowing me into your beautiful energy. We have the Moon. And we have the Knight of Swords. Okay. And let's pull some of these as well. Spirit, clear and concise message for beautiful pile number two. What are they healing exactly? Page of Cups. Okay. What do they need to know about this healing? We got the Death card. And one more card here. We have the Ten of Pentacles. How beautiful. Talk about legacy and family and more bumblebees. You guys, the dedication you guys are putting in right now in your life, in this 3D world, I feel like You guys are hard workers, okay? So aside from heart chakra healing, I feel like you're able to dedicate yourself to a legacy, to a project in this world that is able to leave a legacy for your family, okay, your children, your grandchildren. And I feel like it's all on the back of your hard work and your ability to stay dedicated. But aside from this physical work, excuse me, I'm gonna cough for a second. I feel as though you guys are also healing your heart energy, which is a little bit more in the subconscious, okay, with the moon here. I feel like there is suppressed energies here that you're able to really heal and work on. And the Knight of Wands does not shy, or the Knight of Swords and the King of Wands does not shy away. These are two of the most confident energies in the tarot that face an opportunity and a challenge head on, the right timing, and they go after exactly what they need to do in order to capture what it is that they want and what it is that they need. Okay, they don't shy away. The King of Wands is an opportunistic knight or knight king to go after their his desires and is very confident, solid, knows what it is that he wants and is very mature and experienced, whereas the Knight of Swords is very quickest moving knight in the deck, faces challenge, is very, could be very confrontational if he needs to be, but is also not, doesn't shy away from challenge and keeps asking questions in order to get a better understanding. And I feel like there is this desire around an area that maybe you recently uncovered around emotions or heart matters or something that involves your heart energy here with this Page of Cups that hasn't been explored before with the page talking about novice energy. I feel like there is this uncovering, this gentleness, this youthfulness. Okay, this also being youth with the little star here. There's something that's uncovered that's very precious, okay? And I feel like you're uncovering this maybe for the first time. And I feel like there is this rebirth and this exiting out of a state where maybe this energy was closed off. And now you're able to open this up because you've been asking questions and digging into the subconscious, okay? So I feel like, yeah, there's been working diligently and physically, okay, as a honeybee would, and staying dedicated, but I also feel like you're dedicated to uncovering truths about an area of your psyche, an area that's in your subconscious when it comes to your heart healing. And it could very well be your inner child experience, something that's made you worry, something that you've been held back by. And not only you, but I feel like your lineage here. And with these two pillars, I feel like there still is a choice here. And I feel like this choice will liberate you here with this bird flying free, either of these choices. So I feel like the message here is there isn't a wrong choice. There is an opportunity for you to break free and make a decision that will either way liberate you, okay, from a situation here that maybe is needed to come to an end. Now we'll look at some more tarot, see if we could get some more about this because it sounds very exciting. And yeah, and then we'll pull some timelines. So spirit, okay, well, we have the tower coming in reverse here. So pleasant surprise here. Can we get some more about this decision, these two options, these choices that pile number two has to make? And more about their healing and their journey, the next big blessing coming in. Thank you so much, Spirit. We have the Four of Cups in reverse, and we have the Queen of Wands. Wow, this is beautiful. Okay, let's pull some of these tarot cards now. Spirit, some more information, please, and thank you. We have the Five of Wands. Okay. We have the Ten of Cups, you guys, and we have, well, this one wanted to come out. We have the Six of Pentacles, and this one wanted to come out as well with the Four of Swords. Okay, healing. I think we see cards here. Worry, healing, 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 healing. Okay, by the book, talking about lineage, talking about lineage. There was a point where you felt conflict, where you felt challenged, where you felt very challenged. And I think you'll be pleasantly surprised here with the Tower in reverse, that there will be an opportunity for you to come out of a state where you were feeling maybe like you were unable to see past a certain point when it comes to emotions, okay? Because this is the apathy card, maybe someone not being able to see what is in front of them when it comes to emotional matters, and maybe in a state of lack or just boredom, not into it. With this in reverse, I feel like you're coming out of a state where there's a situation that seemed more like conflict than it did like a solid foundation. But I feel like not only are you coming out of this state of boredom, you're coming as this powerful Queen of Wands. And we did see the King of Wands and the Knight of Swords. Queen of Wands is also, like the King of Wands, very powerful when it comes to manifesting what it is that she wants, okay? She is very much one that will attract her heart's desires. And with the law of attraction here, she is able to bring into her whatever it is that's going to bring her happiness. And I feel like not only is it able to resolve an area that needed healing from conflict, but it also brings this beautiful Ten of Cups, which is complete emotional fulfillment. Okay, here we have the whole family. Again, family is emphasized here. Okay, so if you're wanting a family, maybe this is an existing family, but I feel like there's this family support, there's this family legacy. And the Six of Pentacles talks about a give and take, reciprocity, donations. But I feel like in this card, two hands are receiving what is rightfully theirs. I feel like you're receiving what is rightfully yours when it comes to material wealth and a balance, a shift balance of emotional wealth, financial and material wealth. And you're attracting this in by shifting the energy here once you heal, okay? And I feel like you're able to heal based on your dedication and your focus, shifting away from conflict and areas that maybe you felt like you were challenged. Okay, so beautiful energy. Let's ask Spirit for when can you expect to see this beautiful blessing. Spirit, can we get timelines for beautiful pile number two regarding their blessing? When can they expect to see this beautiful surprise, this blessing? Ooh, we got quite a bit here. Let's see what it says. So we have no need to worry. Okay, so you have been worried. Okay, this has come out twice. So an area of your life you're really worried about, and I feel like you're able to heal this. You're really able to finally overcome this, where you're not needing to worry anymore. You're not needing to feel like you're in conflict. You're coming out of this state, okay? And it's shockingly so, because I feel like a lot of you guys feel like almost it's not that it was hopeless, maybe you felt it was hopeless, but I feel like you're so worried that you wouldn't be able to turn things around here, okay? Yes, positivity. The answer is yes. Reconsider. Okay, so I feel like for some of you guys, there is a need to shift from this worry to reconsider the possibilities here, right? We're coming out of a state where we might have felt like shaky foundation, maybe we were bored, in the state of apathy. We're reconsidering what is ours, what can we have for ourselves with this Ten of Cups, what can we manifest, okay? And recovery, again, another healing card. Okay, so I also feel like with this reconsider before the recovery, Spirit is saying before forward movement, and I feel like this stands to reason, and I don't think a lot of you guys would be moving forward so much with that King of Wands and that Knight of Wands or Knight of Swords. We were saying, I feel like there's a heavy emphasis on healing heart energy, okay, recovery, fully recovering here with this Four of Swords. Focusing on your dedication here, like this honeybee is focused on work, is very dedicated, okay? And I feel like then you're able to come out of a state where then you're able to open your hands and receive what is rightfully yours and go after this beautiful Ten of Cups. You don't even have to go after. I feel like all you got to do is be in a state of receiving, ask the universe for it, and you'll receive it. And I feel like the healing here allows for you to be able to manifest, allows for you to be able to see the positivity, because I feel like you're in a state right now of worry and in a state that is potentially has blocked your ability to manifest and bring into what you desire here. But remember, the answer is yes. And here too, with the two options, we didn't see anything here with what your options would be or what those choices are. And I am tempted to pull some more here just to see what are these two. Like, I know it talked about focusing on the 3D plane here when it comes to being dedicated to work and your material abundance and also your healing. But what are these two options here for beautiful pile number two, Spirit? Can we get some more on these two options, these two decisions, these two areas? Oh, two areas could very well be the healing of your heart chakra and then your ability to build your abundance, your stability, with your family. Ten of Pentacles, you guys, Ten of Pentacles, this is leaving your legacy when it comes to building something worthwhile, your legacy, your fortune, your retirement plan, okay, leaving stability for your family. So not only is it healing your heart and traumas and pain that might get passed down from generation to generation or has been passed down from lineage, but it's also building this stability. Ten of Pentacles, this is the most abundant card here in building an empire, building a future. Okay, so I feel like both of these options is not even a choice. This is both options are definitely out there for you to attain. And I feel like this healing water is something that you're able to focus on. And yeah, I feel like your next big blessing is you're able to accomplish both of these areas of your life, overcome healing, overcome being dedicated and very studious when it comes to building your empire and leaving a legacy for your children. Okay, and yeah, this is beautiful. All right, so no need to worry. Beautiful pile number two. I hope this helped. And if you're drawn to another pile, I will see you there. If not, thank you so much and we'll see you soon. Bye. Hello, my spectacular pile number two. If you pick this mother of pearl tortoise or abalone, I don't know, seashell turtle tortoise, then this will be your beautiful reading. Now, this was inspired by my last reading that I did, and I felt I left pile number three a little bit sad, and I did not want to do that because I wanted to leave an upbeat message. So we asked Spirit for the next big blessing, the next big pleasant surprise coming in. Maybe it's something expected, maybe it's something completely unexpected, but it's something positive, something pleasurable. What's the next big blessing coming in for you guys? Beautiful pile number three. Let's take a look what we have. We have Selenio. Number 20, the inner temple, life lessons. I go within my shadow for deep spiritual growth. Wow, and look at all her beautiful jewelry. All right, so I pre-shuffled these, and then we'll pull some tarot as well. Look at this crystal. Golden in hydro herkimer, sunshine, vitality, joy. Containing floating gold liquid, gold in hydro herkimer is named after the oil suspended within the crystal, rare and possessing wisdom from the Himalayas, where it is found. This stone stimulates the third eye and enhances intuition and connection to the universe. Golden in hydro herkimer promotes gender fluidity and acceptance, assisting in transitions and connecting with one's gender or healing wounds. Strongly tied to the solar plexus, golden in hydro herkimer can clear out emotional baggage from many lifetimes. Live out loud and proud, Sagittarius and Sun. Wow, okay, that was powerful. And then this crystal right here looks like cauliflower, blue cauliflower, blue aragonite, empathy, compassion, communication. Communication is key. With blue aragonite, you will definitely send the message. Blue aragonite activates the throat, third eye, and heart chakras. Wow. Allowing you to communicate from a whole and centered place, while the stone instills hope and inspiration. This crystal enhances your ability to emphasize and show compassion for others, fostering authentic connections. Blue aragonite communication skills also carry across when you're communicating with the spirit realm, cultivating a calm and relaxed space for even more clarity to come through. Capricorn and earth energy. Wow. I feel like there's something coming up now that you're learning to embrace here. Let's see some more. Here and now with the number 32 or the number 5. Here and now, that could be big changes. All right. And we have this beautiful card here, the Worker. Number 6, affirmation. I enjoy getting in touch with who I am as an individual. Wow, there is a heavy emphasis on who you are and your authenticity, living to your authentic self. Where there's a will, there's a way. I am kind. Beautiful. Snake. Okay. Interesting. And Earth with the number 24. The frequency of Earth activates our deep connection to this physical plane by showing us the beauty of all the aspects of our great mother and revealing the more ethereal spiritual aspects of our nature. And we had Earth here as well with, yeah, Earth. Heavy emphasis on Earth. Keeping it real. Keeping it real. And the snake might talk about maybe there's a part of your life where you feel you cannot be yourself or have not been able to be your authentic self. Speak your truth, see your truth, be in the here and now, and completely enjoy the moment because you've been in a certain way, okay? Yeah, I feel like you've been in a certain way that hasn't been allowing you to fully be real and enjoy the moment. And okay, let's pull some tarot and see if we could see some more here. Spirit, can we get a clear and concise message for beautiful pile number 3 for the next big blessing coming in? What can they expect to see here? We have the Queen of Cups. Beautiful energy here with water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. We have the Devil and we have the World. So we have Capricorn coming out again here with the Capricorn and Earth. Okay. And the World. Okay. So let's pull some more tarot and then we'll get into channeling what this is all about. So we have the Three of Cups. Beautiful. We have the Two of Cups. Oh, you guys. And we have the Ace of Wands. Okay. I feel a strong message for you guys. There's a part of your life that you've been suppressing, maybe held back because you haven't been able to embrace what you truly feel. And you've been unable to experience the pleasures, okay? With the Three of Cups, this is somebody enjoying and celebrating and coming together and having very lighthearted in the here and now and celebrating, okay? Here and now. Where there's a will, there's a way. And I feel like something potentially was telling you that you're not allowed to, or you're unable to be in a certain way because you're appearing and encompassing a different energy that's not quite you. It's not aligned to who you truly are, okay? And I feel like you're being, your next big blessing here is you're being in an energy of somebody who goes within, takes a look at what truly matters when it comes to your true deep passions. There's nothing more emotionally deep than this Queen of Cups, who is absolutely beautiful when it comes to sharing, giving emotions from the heart, being genuine, being authentic, being intuitive, being in touch with spiritual realms, and kind-hearted and open and genuine when it comes to love. And I feel like what you're putting an end to here is a cycle of being held back in a way where you weren't living to your authentic, genuine desires, where you were not allowing yourself to celebrate a part of your life. Maybe, because it was talking here about acceptance. Okay, so it doesn't necessarily have to be accepting your gender, but it says healing wounds. So potentially you didn't allow yourself to enjoy a situation because you had emotional baggage. You weren't able to allow yourself to release this contentment because you've been held up in areas where you're telling yourself that you had to heal or that you weren't allowed to feel a certain way. Okay, but Spirit is saying you will be in the here and now, you'll be grounded, you'll be able to shed what maybe was a false skin or a way of being and put an end to this. Okay, with this world talking about a cycle coming to an end. And I feel like it could very well be getting into relationship. It could be how you are perceived by other people, how you connect with other people, your genuine face, your genuine self, how you're able to communicate, okay, authentically, give them energy, give them love, how you're able to receive the love they're able to give you, how you're able to reveal true parts of yourself without holding back the truth. And I feel like not only are you able to do that, I feel like there is this desire, okay, with this Ace of Wands, this talks about inspiration, new beginnings, and a desire. I feel like you really rise above any situation that maybe you were in for a very long time, because the lilies talk about maturation and potentially a long period of time where things took some time to mature. Maybe you had baggage for quite some time. You're able to release and work your way out of this state, and now you're inspired to be your true self, to shed any sort of false skin or ways of being that you no longer want to carry, so you can enjoy this Three of Cups and enjoy it with other people. Three of Cups is your social network, how you're able to celebrate with people. Okay, and I mean, if you're held back, you're not and not authentic, you're not really able to fully enjoy yourself or open yourself up to a relationship here with the line here with the courage. I feel like you have the courage in order to set yourself free to connect here. Okay, and we also have here this what is it? This flower that grows out of mud. You know what I'm talking about. It's not coming to me. It's not a lily, but anyway, this flower here, it grows in the mud, and I feel like you come from a challenging situation where maybe there was a lot of baggage. Maybe you weren't able to embrace who you truly were, and you not only were able to develop and flourish, but now you're coming to a point where you're able to give and take in situations with other people, genuinely. Okay, you're able to rise above due to your dedication, your ability to focus and stay dedicated. Wow, and here we have beautiful cherry blossoms. Okay, so yeah, I feel like you guys are embracing who you are, what it is that makes you happy, being in the here and now. And with this worker card, I enjoy getting in touch with who I am as an individual. I feel like maybe a lot of you guys have shifted. Maybe areas where it would result in expressing your emotions or areas of joy and celebration when it comes to emotional matters, relationships, friends, you'd rather be or have been focused on work. But the blessing is you're able to get in touch with who you are as an individual, and an individual is more than just work. An individual is able to celebrate and be open to emotions. Okay, the devil energy is Capricorn energy, and this is someone who's also very dedicated to work. So I feel like maybe you've been very, very work orientated, which is great, but at the expense of being able to enjoy another side of you here. Okay, and I feel like this is grounding you, this is allowing you to be in the here and now. Where there's a will, there's a way. There's a possibility for you to enjoy this. Okay, where maybe in the past you didn't think that you were able to due to maybe past pains or here is maybe where you felt shame or you felt like you weren't respecting a certain part of yourself or honoring something here that you're supposed to be honoring here with the I am kind. I feel like Spirit is asking you to be kind to yourself. So maybe you've judged yourself in areas. Okay, so we're going to pull some more here just to see. Two of Cups coming out again. I didn't remove this queen. We're going to put her away. See if she wants to come out again. Yeah, there's a heavy emphasis here on a give and take partnership here. So it could be one person specifically in a partnership, but it could just be how you are able to show up in relationships to others. Okay, how you provide emotional support or give of emotional support to others. I feel like you're being liberated or free to do this. Look at this, the Lovers, you guys. If there isn't somebody very special in your life right now, I feel like the energy's shifting. And the Ten of Pentacles, okay? This is building something solid, stable, that will last the test of time. Very secure, legacy, retirement, building a home, a family structure. It's very stable, okay? Lovers is a choice. Choosing what you love, going after what you love, being in the here and now to choose what you feel is right for you emotionally. The Lovers again. You guys saw me shuffle. Wow, you guys are choosing love. This is amazing. And I mean, love does not, I feel for a lot of you guys, it is with somebody else. But if it's not, I feel like you're allowing love into your heart. You're allowing yourself to love. Love yourself. Shed a skin, maybe how you've been showing up. Temperance, balance, healing. Okay, if you've had baggage, you're able to alchemize some of this baggage and bring into this world healing so that you can balance out energies where maybe you've been very imbalanced, very focused on work, very focused on other areas. Where there's a will, there's a way. Two of Pentacles. Again, two, 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 two. Okay, so I feel like there is this emphasis on you deciding to choose yourself, deciding to balance work and emotions, balance your life and things you enjoy doing. Okay, there is this like need for you to know that your life involves both aspects of you, and I feel like that's what your blessing is. You're able to embrace both sides of you. Okay, embrace love here. This is Gemini energy. Okay, wow, and Sagittarius energy. Very beautiful. I do want to see some more. I'm very excited to see what comes out. Thank you, Spirit. That is beautiful. So for the blessing here, for beautiful pile number three, what can they expect to see out of this outcome when they're able to give emotions and love and choose wisely based on their emotions and their authentic self? What can they expect from this blessing? Thank you so much, Spirit. So we have the Ace of Wands coming out again. Okay, that's heavy passion and desire. Two of Cups again, you guys. How many times are you going to see this Two of Cups? I think you guys have a person here you're really into. You're really inspired to move towards, okay? So I feel like if this isn't your wake-up call to do that. And the Queen of Wands coming out again. Okay, so maybe somebody you're really attracted to here with this Queen of Wands. If you're the Queen of Wands and you're very passionate and you're bringing in what you desire, which is this give and take, this relationship, this partnership. This is someone very attracted to someone, okay, with this Ace of Wands, going after their dreams and desires. Okay, lots of passion, lots of passion, lots of emotion. And wow, so we're getting again Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy, heavy, beautiful. What else, Spirit, can they expect? I think there's like, yeah, this beautiful partnership that you guys are really wanting to bring in, that you guys are attracted to. The Queen of Cups coming out again, you guys. This is beautiful, emotional queen that is very emotionally mature. She is Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, very intuitive, creative, just beautiful, can give and take. And the King of Cups. I love these readings, you guys. Look at the divine couple. You're able to share, give and take. A divine partnership. You and somebody else who's equally as loving and expressing emotions. Ace of Cups, an emotional new beginning. I'm totally leaving that like that. You guys deserve an emotional new beginning. This is love, loving self, allowing oneself to love self, release from any holdups, the devil energy, where you've been focused on maybe other areas of your life and fully dedicated. Now allow yourself to find a way to have an emotional new beginning, shed some old ways of being, be kind to yourself. Okay, I go within my shadow for deep spiritual growth. Wow, indeed, deep spiritual growth. Let's pull some timing cards here so we can know when can pile number three expect this beautiful blessing. So excited. Let's pull those. Wow, this might be a lot, but we'll see what we have. Listen to your intuition. Okay, so I feel like, yes, definitely on the journey of listening to your intuition. Okay. We have opportunity. I feel like there's definitely an opportunity here with a new beginning, two new beginnings, desired, inspired action, going and driving towards what we want, and emotional new beginning, and bringing in with the law of attraction, this partnership, okay, around emotions, giving, loving, look for a sign, okay? So I feel like a lot of you guys will have to lean on your intuition, look for signs, but we still got three more cards to go. Romance. This is a romance reading, you guys. Emotionally beginning, give and take, and look how beautiful. Two people sharing love. Lover's card again. This is you guys opening up to love. What a big blessing coming in here. In the near future. Okay, so spirit just loves not giving information because they feel like spirit really wants you to use your guidance and intuition. Perfect timing. So out of all these cards, with timing, a bunch of vague cards, but I feel like this is perfect because I do feel like this is divine timing and I do feel like this is a divine partnership, okay? So if for those of you guys not looking for a romantic partnership, maybe this is not your reading, but I do feel like there is a divine couple here with the Queen and King of Cups, potential soulmate with this divine timing, with the lovers coming out. And the Two of Cups multiple times, lovers multiple times, okay? Queen of Wands, King of Wands. I feel like you guys are definitely bringing in romance, but I feel like this is because you're able to embrace your authentic self and really look at what it is that you might have been hanging on to as something that wasn't serving you that you're able to shed, okay? So beautiful energy. I'm going to leave it right here. Perfect timing. I love, love, love doing this reading for you guys. Hopefully this helped, and I will see you guys soon. Bye.